I kind of got a head start though. Like before I signed with Young Money, I kind of got to be around like different artists. So I kind of learned the grind of like touring and how important that was. You know what I'm saying? Not to just kind of sit back. You know, so it just takes other people time to learn.
Rack city bitch, rack city bitch. 10, 10, 10, 20s on your titties, bitch. 100 deep VIP, no guest list. TT raw, you don't know who you fucking with.
There's no beef with you know, racks on racks or nothing like that. You didn't come back.
Nah, man, Rack City, we on some whole other shit. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Rack City, we made the whole city about racks. You know what I'm saying?
Go let the man's last king killing shit. Young money, yeah, we getting rich. Put your grandma on my dick. Girl, you know what it is.
How are the strip joints in L.A.? Are they still cool?
Actually, they just opened up a new strip club. It used to be called King of Diamonds.
Okay.
It's
in LA.
It's called Rack City now.
Nah, come on, serious?
I'm not lying.
Wow, did they pay you for that?
Nah, but yeah, we.
I'm sure you got
serve
like
them some papers. So I get back to LA.
Speaking of getting like residuals, did you get any residuals from like all the snapback companies and stuff? Because you know that.
Nah, but I did get New Era. The company New Era brought me in.
Oh, for real?
Yeah, and they wanted to like. I think basically they just want to steal all my ideas and stuff. I don't know, but they brought me in and, you know, I went through like a million snapbacks and they wanted to get my opinion on this and this and this.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
You're like a liaison? They're paying you for that? That's ill.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
Get the fuck out of here.
We didn't tell them all the secrets.
What? I'm about to do a record called Fitted Tobacco or something, man. My hairline is crazy. I can't be walking around my shit. Your hairline is cool and stuff.
My shit kind of, you know. Hey, but I got bitches. You feel me?
What you doing for Christmas, man? You out there giving people turkeys and shit like that? Racks and racks?
Yeah. Man, you know, family and everything. So, you know, that's the holidays time, so.
So you just out there just chilling.
No
you,
special gifts for any whores.
No menage a trois or nothing like that? You ain't got no special Christmas menage? That you
Man.
I be fucking with Chris Brown, man. I know his menages be serious, yo. Jesus Christ, man. What's up with Chris Brown, man? You and him are like so cool together, man. It's like some perfect shit.
Dog,
where did that? Where did that come from, real quick? Because everybody was wondering, is it from the Deuces song?
Nah, we you know, it was a time when he was just chilling in L.A. And then I was recording. I was working. I was in the studio every day. And I was like, yo, just come through. You ain't doing nothing. Just, you know what I'm saying? Just vibe. Okay. And then he was like, yo, I want to rap. Like, let me get on. I thought he was just, I didn't think he was serious.
He actually is really good at rapping.
Nah,
though.
Yeah, he's serious with it, though.
Because there's some R&B singers that's horrible out there. You just need to just sing only.
Yeah.
I saw you in Toronto with Drake. You brought him out. How was
that?
Yeah,
that was crazy. That was like my first solo show out there.
Oh, for real?
Yeah.
Get out of here.
It was wild, too.
You usually go to like Vancouver and up there, or
yeah, I've been to Toronto, but I mean, last time I was there, I performed with Chris, and that was on a tour. But I'm saying my own spot and sold out something that was like 3,000-4,000 people. You know, it was crazy. Drake came out, it was crazy. Now, I don't know if you seen, they got me on World Star. They put some footage up at an after party. These girls, I was like,
fake. Yeah, what's up with that? Like they were underage or something like that. They were.
Nah, I think like
it's okay though.
19
if you're in
is
Europe,
like
though,
the legal
huh?
age or something over there.
Yeah, I mean, what is it, 17 or something?
It's
like
19.
Let me call Bow Wow real quick. Let me ask Bow Wow. What girls you think is crazier, UK or here?
Oh, man, overseas.
Overseas, out of control, right?
Yeah.
Don't you think like it's kind of scary that it's so easy to, or is it just?
Yeah, I mean, well, they love Americans, like, you know what I'm saying? But you just got to be careful because you might get the wrong one that might be musty. I'm serious. That's the only thing. The girls are beautiful over there, but a lot of them don't use deodorant. But what's so crazy is they have.
We were talking about that weeks ago, too.
But what's crazy is they have all the duty free places with millions of fragrances and perfumes and stuff.
That shit don't even make
no
sense.
And they don't use it.
You guys are obviously not the same from like last year when y'all all came together and introed the whole crew. So is there a difference now between amongst each other? Like when y'all interact,
you know,
is everybody different or everybody still the same?
Everybody definitely.
Drake is
still
firing everybody and shit. You're fired.
Everybody's
shut
still
up,
the same,
right?
Man. More money, you know, more bitches.
Yeah. But definitely
but
no
just,
problems.
No.
Okay.
I mean, everybody just matures in their music. Like every time I hear a new Nicki song or a Drake song or somebody new song, it's just like, damn, it just get doper. You know what I'm saying? So that's one thing I've noticed about all of us as artists. Like the music is like just progressing day by day, like every song.
A lot of people are angry that your album got pushed back till next year.
What happened was, I got some samples and stuff, and I like
everything, clearances.
You know, all that. Yeah. All that. Like, see, I don't worry about all the politics stuff. I hate that stuff. Like, I don't worry about like, well, if we can't clear this, I don't care. Like, I'll leak it and put it out in the mixtape. You know what I'm saying? I'm just about the music. So, you know, that's, you got that whole process, and you know, it just takes time. Story, though, it's a theme album. So, you know, like, mixtapes is more just a bunch of songs that kind of you put together, freestyles.
Yeah.
I still got a little bit of that vibe on there, but, I mean, it's like, the music is really good, though.
But even you stated that this is, like, the upgrading of Tyka.
Yeah.
Like,
yeah.
So, everything's going to be different 2012.
Yeah.
Wow. They got these Cape Verdeans. I don't know if you ever met them. They're like,
nah.
They're, like, light-skinned, ill mix.
Yeah.
I think the whole race got, like, raped by the white guy or something, and then they all came out, like, crazy.
Yeah.
People were bugging when the bitch died in the video. Like, that shit was, that shit was crazy, yo.
Well,
like,
I mean, it was, you know, it was kind of like, I really wanted to capture the emotion. You know what I'm saying? I wasn't trying to say, like, oh, she's just dead. Like, this person, I wrote the song about it, they died. It was really just more the emotion, kind of like, you feel this, you felt that way. So I had to show it in order to people to feel that way, you know?
So when you argue with a bitch, you have her meet you on the cliff or some hill somewhere? Like, we ain't got no hills out here, I mean.
No, I just delete her number. It ain't that serious. Like,
meet me on the hill or something.
You know what I'm saying?
when Olivia used to be with us, we used to look at her boobs. And I used to get hard-ons and shit. Like, y'all don't do that shit, yo?
Yo. I know.
Come on, man. No way.
I don't know. Maybe when she first started saying, like, I mean, Nikki, she bad. Like, you know what I'm saying? It's like, then that's your sister.
Yeah.
And it's like, y'all really not related.
Can you explain some of your tats you got out there? Like,
because
you have, like, a lot of Egyptian shit, right, all over you, like.
Yeah. Yeah. It's just basically just energies. Like, I don't know what Illuminati is, though, so I can't.
You ain't meet no alien on the road, right? Like, no.
Nah.
Okay, we got to get that clear because they think that you
People just got to do the research.
Spaceship came down. Tiger was in L.A. or something. I don't know.
I just love the history about it, you know what I'm saying? Just the energy and the vibe it brings, you know.
What's your favorite tattoo? Because, you know, everybody that comes up here, are you addicted to it? Are you going to continue? Because it seems like...
I don't think I'm addicted to getting tattooed, because if I was, I'd be getting tattoos like every day.
Are you the reason Chris Brown got his whole arm done up? Or
I don't know, man. I mean, I've been getting tattooed since I was like 14, yo. So,
oh,
like,
for real?
Everything, like my whole stomach, all my neck, I've been tatted like that since I was like in high school. Like,
oh, for real?
Yeah, so.
Get the fuck out of
here.
A
lot of these tats is old, you know what I'm saying? But it's kind of cool, I guess, if people, it's like a trend or something, that's cool.